here, the host with the most, Jeff Zannini. He'll be moderating us. Everybody give it up for Jeff Zannini.
Salt Lake City, how are you? Man, I love this place, man. You guys are amazing. We're full again, right? Yeah, almost. Get him in the door. All right. We're going to have some fun. Does everyone know the movie already? No, you don't? No, you don't. Those that don't know what you're doing, it's the new Star Wars. All right. Now, we got a few seats in the back, I noticed, so you're going to have to make up for those that noise when we introduce people, all right? All right. Now, I always say it before everything, I see little faces. This is PG-13 to rated R. Yeah, the sick people are laughing. Listen, there's going to be stuff said. People are going to say things. If you don't want your kids to hear it, the doors are in the back. Don't stick around and complain later. We warned you. All right. Without further ado, now let's get one warm-up. I want, when I say three, I want to hear as loud as you can possibly be, all right? One, two, three. That is why we love Salt Lake. Make sure you tell everyone you want us back so we can keep coming back. All right. First up, you love him. He's a character. He's a Disney legend. Goofy and Pluto, Bill Farmer! All right, next up. You know her, you love her. She is the looks and the beauty up here. Daphne, Scooby-Doo, Ready to Lie! You know him, he has long hair too, he's not me. He's the rock star voiceover, Jess Harnell! We're still waiting for Tom Kenny, but I've got to have a second because I just want to say this publicly. Salt Lake City Comic Con is the best Comic Con in the world! And on that note, he's arrived, folks. SpongeBob's here, Tom Kenny! They're all here, guys. They made it.
What Jess said about Salt Lake City Comic Con, I totally agree.
And dude, somebody asked me, they said, aren't you afraid that somebody's going to put that on YouTube and the other cons are going to see it? And I said, dude, screw it. Let them. It's true.
All right. We're just getting a couple of pens here so we can get everybody going. Yeah, Tom's scared, so you guys be gentle. Be gentle.
Well, Tom's new to voiceover, so go gentle on him, will you?
He's there. He's his first time. All right. Let's see. We're getting pens. Bear with us. Bear with us.
I have been looking forward to this for like a week. How about you?
Have you guys been to one of these before? Have you seen this before?
Yeah.
You know, for those of you who haven't, it's exactly like seeing your favorite movie if it was really, really drunk.
All right, we got pens. Are you guys ready?
We've got pens.
Here we go.
We're ready.
Here we go. Pens. Here.
The pens are here.
We got pens. All right.
The new phone books are here.
We're going to open up. Let's see here. We're going to go. We're going to start out. Let's see. Scene one. We're going to start right at the beginning. As Poe. Gray. How about Vicky?
All right.
Fairly Odd Parents.
All right.
As Captain Phasma. Bill. Daffy Duck.
All right.
As Laura Santeca. Jess. Pee Wee Herman.
He's back. He got arrested for masturbation.
I told you, get your kids out.
Well, he did, dude. They know.
All right. As Kylo Ren, none other than the legend of Goofy.
Oddly enough, Goofy almost played Kylo Ren in the movie.
As, okay, you know when you love this, and I'm doing this selfishly, as BB-8, Jess, Christopher Walken. And then to keep Tom busy, we're coming out of the gates punching, guys. This scene is going to be narrated by SpongeBob SquarePants. So set your recorders. Set your recorders, because SpongeBob's about to read the opening scroll to Star Wars. All right, when you guys are ready, we're up.
All right. It's a long scroll. I'll go fast. A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away, Star Wars Episode 7, The Force Awakens! I'm getting to that, Gary. Luke Skywalker has vanished. In his absence, the sinister First Order has risen from the ashes of the Empire and will not rest until Skywalker, the last Jedi, has been destroyed. With the support of the Republic, General Leia Organa leads a brave resistance, and also brief. She is desperate. I'm wearing my briefs here in my pineapple. She is desperate to find her brother Luke and gain his help in restoring peace and justice to the galaxy. Leia has sent her most daring pilot on a secret mission to Jakku, where an old ally has discovered a clue to Luke's whereabouts. Jakku Village, night. Suddenly a droid rises into frame. This is BB-8. In a primitive hut, an old rugged explorer, Laura Santeca, has handed a mysterious sack to Poe Dameron. Poe has charisma, a magical spark.
Babe. Bibbidi Buzz. Buzzity Ding Dong Beep.
This will begin to make things right. I traveled too far, fast, and weighed too much to ignore the
despair in the galaxy. Without the Jedi, there can be no balance in the Force.
Well, because of you, now we have a chance. The General's been after this for a long time.
The General.
To me, she's royalty.
Bibbidi boo. Bussy bus buzz wow. Sizzle zort.
We've got company, twerp. You have to hide.
She said you have to leave.
Go!
Yikes! Approaching enemy ships. Stormtroopers come out firing blasters. The villagers fire back.
Come on, BB-8, hurry!
Babe. Beepity buzz, babe. Wow, sizzle, zork, beep.
Yeah, I see him.
Dude, they're all waiting for it, though. Babe, buzz, stab him in the face with a soldering iron. It doesn't say that. I made that up. That's not it.
Safer with you than it is with me. You get as far away from here as you can. You hear me, twerp?
Babe. Buzz, babe. Buzz, baby, to do, babe. Wow.
I'll come back for you. It'll be all right.
Hey. Wow, babe. Buzz and Zord. It's crazy. Nuts. Wow.
An imposing shuttlecraft lands near the transport vehicles. The door opens. Psh, Kylo Ren exits the ship. A tall, dark figure. He strides through the chaos towards Santeca. He wears a dark mask marked by battle.
Oh, look out. You be careful.
Yes, but something far worse has happened to you.
It was a facelift that went bad. Do you know what I've come for?
I know where you come from
before you called yourself Kylo Ren!
The map to Skywalker! We know you found it, and now you're gonna give it to the First Order.
He sounds like the best Mickey Mouse I have ever heard in my life. Isn't that amazing?
The First Order rose from the dark side. You, did not.
I'll show you my dark, the dark side.
You may try, you goofy bastard.
It doesn't say that, but I made that up too.
But you cannot deny the truth
that is your family.
Kylo Ren sees Poe. He's grabbed by stormtroopers. They kick out Poe's legs. Kylo Ren kneels to look at Poe.
Ow. So, who talks first? You talk first?
The old man gave it to you.
It's just very hard to understand you without the...
Search him!
Apparatus!
Put him on board!
Sir, it's the villagers!
Kill them all!
On my command! Fire!
Let's see.
Dude, that was so messed up.
Yeah. All right. Let's move into scene two quick. All right. We are going to have... Oh, he's coming.
I heard that. He's backstage with a girl and a donkey, dude.
This time, Kylo Ren is going to be Bill Cosby, Jess. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I'm feeling so sleepy all of a sudden. Don't drink this.
All right. And,
accept the cappuccino from Kylo Ren.
As FN2187, or Finn, Tom, let's have the Ice King.
Okay.
Yeah. As Poe, we're going to bring in one of my favorites, Bill, Snagglepuss as Poe.
Okay.
It's going to be narrated gray by Chris Rock's mom.
Okay.
You're going to love that. Let's see. As BB-8 this time, Bill, BB-8 is going to be Pluto.
Okay.
Yes. As Ray, Gray, is going to be Mandy from Grim Adventures. And let's do a couple of Transformers. As General Hux, we're going to have Wheelie, Tom.
Oh, all right.
And Hux. As Unkar, Jess, Ironhide. All right, I think that's everybody, and go.
Okay, because we value your time, I'll summarize the next 7 pages. So everyone is killed in this scene. We find out that one stormtrooper with a conscience didn't fire a shot. And we're supposed to, we introduce a young scavenger named Rey. She saves BB-8, and Poe wakes up shackled to a chair.
Man, I love shackling people to chairs, see? In the resistance on board. Tell me, are you comfortable? Because if you're not, I want you to drink this and you will be.
Oh!
Heavens to Murgatroyd. Not really. Wow, I'm impressed because Goofy sounds exactly like Snagglepuss, man. That was great. No one has been able to get out of you what you did with the map and a bowl of Jell-O pudding.
Listen, you might want to rethink your technique.
Kylo Ren says nothing, reaches out for Poe's face, not touching him. Poe is soon in agony.
Poe, tell me, where is it? The resistance will not be intimidated by you. Where is it?
Paul can't take it. He begins to scream. The door slides up. Kylo Ren exits fierce, confronts General Hux.
General Hux, he told me what I wanted to know because I gave him some pills. It's in a droid, a BB unit, Baha.
Hey, if it's on Jakku, what's shown at?
Well, I leave that to you, along with this bottle of little pills. You take a few and I'll come back later.
Ray stands with BB-8 in line at Unka Plutton. He reveals her goods. He glances quickly at BB-8. Hold on.
Don't give up. He still might show up. Whatever it is you're waiting for, classified. I know all about waiting, like when I wait for that idiot Billy. For my stupid family, they'll be back one day, unfortunately. Come on.
Optimus Prime, have me appraise these five pieces. And they are worth, let me see here, one half portion.
Excuse me, idiot. Last week they were a half portion each.
What about the droid?
Yeah, what about him?
I will pay for him. I find him sexy.
That isn't here, dude.
He's got a lot of diseases, but whatever.
60 portions.
Actually, this dumb droid's not for sale. He's super annoying anyway. Come on.
Optimus, follow the girl and get that droid. And while you're at it, bring me Megan Fox as well.
It's not me, is it, dude? I'm not supposed to say anything now.
It's okay, they like it. All right, good.
Who's the dowry?
Oh, I am. Sorry, that's me.
Chris Rock's mom's old.
Oh, boy. Chris Rock, yes, she's very old.
Awkward. An exhausted handcuffed Poe is walking down the corridor by a stormtrooper who holds a blaster at his body.
Okay, turn here. Listen carefully. You do exactly as I say, and I can get you out of here. Some serious whiz-biz, yo.
Poe, it's not me.
This is a rescue. I'm helping you escape. Can you fly a TIE fighter?
Who's Poe?
Who's Poe? It's Agapus, dude. It's you.
It's an Agapus. Okay. And now, acting. You with the resistance.
Sorry. This way, Pink Lion. Why are you wearing a white shirt with cuffs and no pants? Here, come this way. What? No. I'm breaking you out. Can you fly a TIE fighter?
I can fly anything. Why? Why are you helping me?
Well, because it's the right thing to do, duh.
Hey, listen. You need a pilot.
I need a pilot.
We're gonna do this.
Yeah?
Who's doing what to who? I've still got the pills.
All right, stay calm.
I'm sweating, but I am calm.
I'm talking to myself.
See? That's it. All right, okay. So, we'll move into the next one. Yeah, next scene. All right. There's no page 9, just so you know. We got rid of page 9.
I hate that.
We're going to have a narrator. How about cat dog, guys? Yeah. Yeah. Cat dog? Yeah. Folks, Jason Isaacs is here.
You got no
Salt Lake, bro. Jason Isaacs, let's hear it.
Just let him do the whole thing, man.
Hey, you guys know who he is? Yeah? A few of you have seen Harry Potter, I think that's what it's called, right?
I am so out of my fucking depth. Apparently, oh dear, this is going to go badly wrong. That was the microphone, but I didn't say that word. They are ventriloquists as well. But it is.
Yes.
All right.
All right. Well, hey, let's change things up now that we have a guest star.
Just the time, too.
All right. All right, let me change a few things. All right, we're going to have a narrated cat dog.
Oh, dog.
Y'all remember cat dog, right? We got dog here. All right.
Jim Cummings was cat, so I'll just have to do the dog part.
Let's see. General Hux, Gray. How about Edith Bunker? I just love that voice.
Oh, all right. I can do that. Yeah.
All right. As Poe, Jess, we got to have Wacko Warner.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Wacko's there. Jason, how about you can be Finn? FN2187 or right. Finn, whatever it says, that's your part. Should you right. Pen?
Yeah, we're good.
You want to mark it?
All right. Finn is FN2.
All right, he's Finn.
That's a person?
Yes. First Order Colonel Bill, how about Sylvester the Cat?
Sylvester.
All right. And then as Lieutenant Mitaka, Jess, I want you to sing your lines as Michael McDonald. Come on, dude. Those of you that have seen this, you love it.
It's real stupid. You're going to like it.
You're going to love it.
Yuma be there. Come on.
You're all sick and twisted, and you know it. All right. Whenever you guys are ready.
Great.
So just so you know, because people might not recognize this, I'm going to try and be Ian McKellen. And when that goes badly wrong, I'm going to switch to Sean Connery. Just so you know.
Folks, Jason and I is going to do whatever he wants, and you're going to love it.
Duke, Lucius Malfoy just borrowed my pen.
It's unbelievable. Keep it.
So cool. Interior TIE Fighter, FN2187 and Poe drop into the back-to-back cockpit. Poe fires up the ship with excitement.
Hello, Salt Lake City.
That was for all of you who think I don't know where I am, dude, because I do.
I always wanted to fly one of these things. Tell me, can you shoot?
Blasters, yes, I can.
Wow, that was amazing, Jason. That was great, dude. Okay.
Okay, it's the same principle. You hit the toggle on the left to switch between missiles, cannons, and magpuls, then use the spire on the right to aim, triggers to fire.
This is very, very complicated.
No, it's just like Grand Theft Auto.
We see the ship struggle to rise. Cables are connected to it.
I can fix this.
We have an unsanctioned departure from Bay 2. Alert General Hux and stop that fire.
The TIE Fighter lifts off from the bay, rips the charging cables. Stormtroopers fire mega blasters. FN2187 tears up parked TIE Fighters and hits the controller room.
Uh-oh.
Continue on next page.
Yeah.
Sorry, Cat. Lasers blast from the TIE Fighter. A series of cannons explode.
Yes. Thank you. Did you see that? Did you see that?
Mic drop!
He's right.
Yes, I saw it. Hey, what's your name?
FN2187. Trips off the tongue, doesn't it?
FN, the what's up, Macaloma, who?
That's the only name they ever gave me.
Well, I ain't using it. I'm gonna call you Dadu. All right, Finn. I'll call you Finn. Is that all right?
Finn, I suppose. I like that.
I like that.
Well, I'm Poe. Poe Dameron, and I'm not wearing any pants.
I know.
It's good to meet you, Finn.
Oh, yes, that's right. It says Finn here speaking. Good to meet you.
Yeah. Hello. Good to meet you as well. You're very sexy in person.
You only say that because I'm a wizard.
Your name bridge. General Hach looks over the shoulder of Lieutenant Mataka at a console. It's very important that you know that he's looking at a console.
So they're taking out a turbo laser.
Ah, watchy. Use the ventral cannons, huh?
Yes, sir. I'm bringing them online.
I don't know. Who's Kylo Ren, dude?
Kylo Ren is
not on your list.
He's not here.
I'll do Anita Baker.
Yeah.
General Hux, it is the right.
That was Kylo Stimpy.
And then I thought,
yeah, and he had help from one of our own. Oh. We're checking the registers now to identify which stormtrooper it was.
From the village, FN2187.
Yeah! Yeah!
So the central cannons are really hot. They're burning up! Yeah, yeah!
I fire just because. I fire just because. Just because I do. Ba 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 boo. Ba 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 ba.
Massive warhead launchers spin and fire blast towards a TIE fighter. This thing is more sophisticated than a garbage truck.
Say that again?
The TIE fighter pulls a big turn back toward Jakku, the sandy planet where Poe left BB-8. Oh, one's coming right for you. My right, your left, do you see it?
Hold on, I shit, Money Bennett. See what I did there?
Yeah, I'm switching it up, man.
Where are you going?
Wow, nice shot, Mr. Bond.
Oh, yes, and where are you going?
Well, we're going back to the water tower, that's where.
No, no, no. We can't go back to Jakku. We need to get out of this system.
Well, I gotta get to my parents before the fourth quarter hits.
What? A droid?
Yeah, that's right. He's a BB unit. Orange and white, one of a kind.
I don't care what color he is. No droid can be that important.
I don't care what color he is either, because we are the world. We are the children. Sorry. No, this one is, pal.
We need to get as far away from the First Order as we can. We go back to Jakku, we die.
That droid's got a map that leads straight to Luke Skywalker, who incidentally in real life is a bigger geek than any one of you guys. Seriously.
You've got to be kidding me.
All right, see.
Jason Isaacs!
He can't stay. He's got to go. Let's hit it.
Keep your eye on him. That kid's going places.
I can't believe he just dropped in. That was amazing.
That's weird. All right. He told me he had nothing else to do all day. Oh, well.
His line was really short, so he just figured, you know, I'm not doing anything.
All right, moving on. All right, next scene. Let's see. Captain Phasma. How about Judy Garland, Dorothy, Wizard of Oz?
You want me to do that?
Gray. As the technician, Tom, can we bring Heifer?
Sure! Yeah!
Those are the real fans screaming.
Yeah.
All right.
Salvation!
For Ray, Gray, we're going to have Daphne from Scooby-Doo. The narrator, Bill, how about Yogi Bear? Yogi Bear. As Finn, Tom, how about Rabbit? No? He doesn't want to do Rabbit. You want to do someone else? Yeah?
Let's do the Mayor of Townsville. He's more fun.
Mayor of Townsville. All right.
More fun than
Forget
Rabbit.
Rabbit. We're doing the Mayor of Townsville.
As Kylo?
As Ren. As Finn.
Finn. Sorry.
Finn is the Mayor of Townsville. Kylo Ren.
Don't mention Finn.
Bill is going to be Tweety Bird.
Tweety Bird. Okay.
As BB-8, Jess. How about Ozzy?
Oh, yeah.
And last but not least, General Hux, Eric Cartman. Whatever you want.
Okay.
Gray's gonna switch it up, so just pay attention.
Okay. Captain Faz will be Daphne, and Ray will be Judy Garland.
Okay. Are you ready?
Okay. That's my mom.
Ready?
Take one.
Hey, suddenly they are hit. The TIE fighter spirals out of control toward the surface of Jakku. Hey, Captain Phasma and General Hux stand before a holographic projection detailing FM-2187 service records.
Oh, jeepers! Jeepers, FM-2187 reported to my division, was evaluated, and sent off to Crete via reconditioning.
No past signs of nonconformity, you guys.
Well, jeepers, no. This is his first offense. Oh.
Gerald, they've been hoot. Oh, wait. Gerald, they've been hit. That was a hoot.
Destroyed?
Disabled. They were headed back to Jakku. The fighters projected to crash in the Gozan Badlands.
Oh, is that me? Oh, yeah. Sorry, dude. I get confused.
They were going back to the drone. I mean, it's back to the wreckage. Supreme Leader Smoke is explicit. Capture the drone if you can, but destroy it if you must, you guys. Ooh, how capable are your soldiers, General? Hey, I won't have you question my methods. Respect my authority, you son of a bitch. They are always easy scared at committing high treason. Perhaps we the smoke to consider using a quote enemy. My men are exceptionally trained, programmed from birth. They are not poor like Kenny or Jews like Kyle. Kyle Ren. Then they should have no problem relieving the droid or themselves unharmed. Careful then that your personal interests do not interfere with others who need us. No. Ooh, I want that map. For your sake, I suggest you get it.
Oh, there's external, name my outpost, day. Hey! Sun scorched and exhausted. Finn stumbles out of the desert into the outpost. Ray talks to PBA.
Hold on a minute. Now, who? Him?
Blossom, buttercup, water.
Now hold on a minute. What's your hurry, thief?
How did it work, thief?
He was turned to steel in a game I meant to feel. Buzzy.
Hey! Apparently the telescopic arm is coming out of it. It's shocking me. It feels kind of bad and kind of good at the same time.
The jacket? Well, now this droid says you stole it.
Look, I've had a pretty messed up day, all right? So I'd appreciate it if you stop accusing me of the cult to stop it.
Shockity, shock, shock, shock.
Now, where'd you get it? It belongs to the wizard, his master.
It belonged to Poe Dameron. That was his name, right? He was captured by the First Order. The previous administration here in Townsville was wrecked up. I helped him escape, but the ship crashed. Poe didn't make it.
Oh, I know how he feels. I almost didn't make it either.
Look, I tried to help him. Sheesh, get all mad. I'm sorry.
Oh, so you're with the good witch, are you? I mean, the resistance.
Yeah, obviously, yes, I am. I'm with the resistance, yeah. I'm with the resistance.
Wow. I'm from Kansas, and I've never met a resistance fighter before.
Well, this is what we look like. Some of us, others will look different.
Well, the Tin Man, I mean BB-8, says he's on a secret mission. He has to get back to your base and back home. He wants to go home. He wants to go home.
I get the truth. I get the truth.
Skywalker, I thought he was just a myth.
No, he's not a myth. He's a Mister.
What is that? What is it?
Let's see. I think we got the thing. You just never know where it's going to go. All right. Next up, we've got, let's see, as Finn, Bill, how about Foghorn Leghorn? One of those seems to be bigger. As Ray Gray, Sam Manson from Danny Phantom. Let's see, there's two one-liners. There's a stormtrooper in BB-8.
Okay.
Tom's gonna do whatever he wants to do.
Okay.
He's gonna surprise you. How's that?
Cool.
Two lines. And then as...
Okay.
You have a stormtrooper in BB-8. And then as the narrator...
Yes?
Jess is gonna change it every time he reads.
Oh, good.
Somebody different every time he reads. Whatever's in his head, you're gonna hear it. Welcome to the inside of Jess's head.
Some of you have been there and you know it.
All right, whenever you guys are ready.
Okay. Well, because Gray just rocked it, it's worth it. I'm going to do the Cowardly Lion for the first one.
Yeah. Those stormtroopers talking to Uncle Stark's point their way. Finn Army then grabs a hand and heads for the tents.
Whoa! What are you doing, Danny? I mean, what are you doing?
I say, come on! Come on, BB-8!
Let go of me! Come on, dude!
Nah, that boy don't pay attention. No, we gotta move.
I know how to run without you holding my hand. BB-8, stay close! Let's go, Ghost!
Call in the airstrike.
They're shooting at both of us!
Yeah, they saw you with me. You're marked.
Well, thanks for that.
Well, I'm not the one who chased you down with a stick. Does anyone have blasters around here?
Are you okay? Stop taking my hand. I'm a vegetarian.
Jess, how about Marlin? Who wants to hear Marlin Finding Nemo?
As they race from the tent, a TIE fighter screams in from behind the tent. Okay. My God, it fires at them! A massive blast sends Ray and Finn flying just like Nemo did in the movie. I hated that. BB-8 was rolling. It's very dangerous. I should stay in the safe part of the ocean.
You okay in the head?
Yeah, follow me.
I say we can't outrun them.
We might in that quad jumper.
We need us a pilot.
We've got one.
You? Well, what about that there ship?
Well, that one's garbage.
Looks like it.
That garbage will do.
Elvis, yeah, I'm gonna do Elvis. The jumper is blown apart in a huge flame ball. Thank you very much. Thank you.
our positions down there.
Dude, Adam West.
Okay. Adam West, dude. I love Adam West. He's, you guys like, he's so cool, right?
You heard of him, Batman? Have you heard of Batman? All right.
He's old a real chum, man. The galaxy is in great danger. Fit and BB-8 follow as they all run toward the piece of junk. And we see it for the first time. The Millennium Falcon.
The gunner position's down there.
You ever fly this thing?
No, dude, this ship hasn't been flown in years, Danny.
Great, I say great. Whoa, I can't do this. I can do this. I can do it.
I can do this. I can do this. Should I? Whoa, hey! Oh, stay low, stay low!
That was my line. Whoa! Hey! Oh, stay low, stay low!
What?
Stay low, lower, lower. It confuses their tracking.
BB-8, hold on! I'm going ghost and I'm going low!
Oh, thank you.
And see. All right, let's see here. Moving on.
What do we got, dude?
We got the next scene. We have...
Are you guys having a good time?
Yeah, right. Remember, your reaction is casting the last two scenes as I hear how you react. All right, in this scene... All right, as Kylo Ren, Captain Hero. As BB-8... We're bringing back Gary the Snail. As Ray Gray Azula.
That's in Montana.
Finn Jess. We haven't heard from William Shatner.
Hey, you guys don't know that he's my neighbor and he thinks I'm Gene Simmons from Kiss, right? He does. It's awesome. I never told him. I lived there for 15 years. He still calls me Gene.
As Lieutenant Mataka, another Transformer, Skids. You'll remember the voice, all right. And narrated, I like the idea of switching it up, Bill. How about you just throw us whatever? I'd love to hear Donald Trump. I'd love to hear Brokaw, Lloyd, Pee-wee, Jimmy Stewart, Howard, you do what you do.
Okay, that's the narrator, right?
Whatever you got, narrated different at one every time.
Okay.
Ready when you are.
Woo!
Let me see, where are we starting?
Page 19.
Page 19. I lost all my pages here. 17, 18, 19.
I'll make it up if I can't find it here. There we go. Okay.
Oh yeah, baby. We gonna be rocking and rolling today, baby. Oh yeah. Behind the Falcon, two TIE fighters scream. They chase him. Ray looks back for a flash. Instead, they are rocked by a flash, baby.
What are you doing back there, you idiot? Are you ever going to fire back with your firebending?
I have Mr. Sulu working on it now. Are the shields up?
You're acting like a weirdo. Not so easy without a co-pilot.
Why don't you try sitting in this thing? Oh, better yet, sit on my lap.
I'll burn you to a crisp if you make a weird pass at me again. Yeah.
Let me tell you, it's incredible. I'm glad I'm here today. I got these incredible... Look at these hands. In shots missed. The TIE fighters are off back in pursuit. Both firing. The Falcon is rocked by another blast. It's incredible.
We need cover quick. We're under attack by God!
Trust is for fools. You shouldn't have trusted. You miscalculated. We're about to get some, I hope.
I hope too.
We need a revolution. The Falcon speeds through a rock formation. The two TIE fighters in pursuit, firing. Finn continues to fire at them, missing.
God damn it. Come on, come.
Don't flatter yourself. You were never even a player. Nice shot, though, I guess.
Get a lot.
And then Finn hits and shatters the TIE fighter. Oh.
Nice shot.
Yes, I'm getting pretty good at this. The TIE fighter fires, hitting the Falcon and jamming the gun into forward position. Alarms blare. It's exactly like Walter Cronkite just said. The cannon's stuck in forward position. I can't move it. You've got to lose them.
Get ready, peasant.
Okay, for what? Are we really doing this?
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Rain scared girds herself as she quickly runs out of space in the wreck. She cuts the power and flips the ship so back faces front. Kind of backwards, woozy walkets now. Ben can now see the pursuing TIE fighter. He fires, destroying it.
He's with the Fire Nation. He's going to get you home. We both will. I don't know your name or care, really, but what is your name?
My name is Finn. What's yours?
Well, I'm Ray, and Ray, together we'll be the most powerful couple in the universe!
Ray, you really should come over. I live next door to Jason.
Help me with this, quick!
What is sculling? Oh!
Internal straw, star, destroy a bridge. Bang! Lieutenant McCutta moves to red. Looks across the star fleet. McCutta swallows, uneasy with his task.
Sir, we weren't able to... Oh, sir, we weren't able to acquire the droid on Jakku. It escaped capture aboard a stolen Corellian YT model fighter.
Are you telling me, Captain Hero, that the droid stole a freighter from me?
Well, not exactly, sir. It had help. We have no confirmation, but we believe FN-2187 may have been helped in the escape.
Who's that?
I don't know who I am.
This happens at sessions all the time.
Okay, I just dozed off.
Usually I'm texting someone and they're like, great, it's your turn.
Hello. Ren ignites his lightsaber, turns and slashes at the console behind him. The horrible sounds of Ren's rage continues.
Those were the horrible sounds of my rage. Tell me, is there anything else?
Well, yeah. The two, they were accompanied by a girl.
Ren reaches out. Makata is suddenly violently pulled forward. Ren into his black glove.
Where is this girl of which you speak? And tell me, did she bring a donkey?
And scene. All right, let's see.
That's one.
I gotta know, the guys and the girls in the back, can you hear us? Are you having fun?
We want to hear from you.
All right, how about you guys up front? Are you having fun? People in the back, we need that. We need you to be listening.
The people in the back need a lot more alcohol. Come to the people in the front because they got a lot.
Yeah.
It's like the milk. It's like the milk in the store. We got to rotate the shelf.
I used to work in the grocery industry. I know. I know the technical terms.
All right. Let's do some favorites now. I'm going to have SpongeBob back because y'all know you love him. SpongeBob's gonna be Ray.
Ray!
We're gonna narrate it. Hey, great. The Good Witch?
Oh, yes, okay.
Glinda the Good Witch. Y'all know who she is, all right. We are gonna have Bill. That Christopher Lloyd was funny. How about Pat Buttram as BB-8?
Okay.
You don't know the name, you'll know the voice. Trust me, come on. All right, and as Finn, Jess.
Oh, jeez.
Arnold Schwarzenegger. You'll get it when you hear the scene. The loyal fans know what's coming.
What's Billy doing?
Billy is doing Pat Buttram, BB-8. We have no idea what he's saying.
Ted Cruz lookalike, Mr. Haney.
Yeah.
Whenever you're ready.
It's all right. You may all come out and thank her. Ray's head pops up from under the grating. An emergency alarm blares.
Ah! It's the motivator!
Can somebody grab me a Harris wrench, please? It's right next to the spatula. I'll check in there.
Tell me, little fellow. How bad is it?
Well, if we want to live, not good.
Listen, there's no need to panic here with me now. They're hunting for us. We got to get out of this system.
BB-8 said the location of the resistance base is a need-to-know basis. If I'm taking you there, I need to know!
BB-8, you got to tell us where the base is.
Beep, beep. Beep, and would you like to buy this genuine used beep?
Stop it! Stop whining! Your mommy's not here to whine a little tushy for you! Between us, I'm not with the resistance, okay? I'm just trying to get away from the First Order. But you tell us where the base is, I get the first deal. Do I please?
Pilex driver, hurry! Pilex. Ask your doctor if Pilex is right for you. Pilex driver, hurry! So, where's your base? My base or yours? What fruit do you live in?
Go on, BB-8. Tell her. Please!
Beep, 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 beep. Say what? The Eilenium system! Come on, Eilenium. The Eilenium system!
Yes, the Eilenium system. That's the one. Get us there as fast as you can.
All right. I'll drop you to it, Ponemon Terminal. It's a really nice place. Right next to the chum bucket. I need the bonding tape, hurry!
Wait, little fellow, tell me. What's your hurry?
I've gotta get back to Jakku!
Back to Jakku? Why does everyone always want to go back to the Jakku?
No, that one. No, the one I'm pointing to. No. The lid. Patrick, the lid. The lid! If we don't patch it up, the propulsion tank will overflow and flood the ship with poisonous gas!
Are you saying it's this?
Yes!
Hey, Ray. Tell me, you're a pilot. You can fly anywhere, you might go back. You got the family, tell me, do you have a boyfriend, a cute boyfriend who maybe works out on his chest and his lats and his biceps and is sexy like me? Does he bench press you late at night?
Yeah. Not near beeswax, that's why.
All right, come here, pick your heels 3 times and repeat after me. Oh shit, the power's out.
Oh, lights out, it's sexy time. This can't be good.
No, it can't be. Someone's locked onto us. All controls are overridden.
Oh, no. It's the First Order.
What do we do? There must be something.
You said the poisonous gas.
Yes, but I fixed that.
Can you unfix it, or can you kiss me deeply on the mouth?
Ray stares at him and gets his
off, grabbing gas masks.
Come on, BB-8.
I got it.
Ooh.
I'm okay. BB-8, get off me.
Okay.
He likes to hump my leg when nobody's looking.
Hey, do you think this will work on the stormtroopers?
Yes, the mask filled out the smoke, not the toxins. It's like a hookah pipe. Hurry!
I'm hurrying!
And see, and the same thing. Where else do you see a former Mr. Olympia hit on a sponge? Seriously. All
right. Man. When we do these, I just make Schwarzenegger a total perv, because I hear he is in real life. Seriously, go online.
All right.
I haven't seen this movie yet, so don't tell me what happened to Han Solo. Is that a spoiler?
They won't tell
you. Does anything happen to Han Solo? I hope not.
No.
Well, I haven't seen it. I don't know anything.
Don't tell him.
All right. Don't tell me.
All right. All right. Bringing back favorites. As Finn, how about... Oh, wait a minute. That's right. Gray, who were you in Foster's?
Frankie, and I was also Dad, Jason, and I was also Barry! And I was flipping at her, too!
I was good. I was good.
Let's bring Foster's. So, yes, Frankie is going to be Finn. And narrated by Eduardo.
Oh, that'll be great! Me amo el narrator!
Alright.
I like potatoes, I'm a narrator.
As
you know, be awful.
As Ray, Bill. Who? Bill Clinton as Ray. Bill Clinton as Ray. As Han Solo, we gotta bring back Christopher Walken.
Yeah.
Alright. And as Chewbacca, Gunther.
Gunther
is Chewbacca.
All right. Got it.
All right, whenever you guys are ready.
Here we go. We are off. Suddenly, the Falcon door opens, and Han Solo and Chewbacca board the Falcon. Weapons are at the ready.
Chewie, we're home.
You know that grating thing that's on the Millennium Falcon? It gets lifted off, and then hands in surrender, they lift up their hands, and they look at hands. Hands.
Hey, wow. Where are the others? Where's the pilot?
I am the pilot.
Oh, no.
Well, I don't know if that's true, but it looks like your wife might be. You?
Wank?
No, it's absolutely true. We're the only ones on board except for a couple of chicks downstairs.
Hey.
Oh my gosh, Blue, you can understand that thing?
And that thing can understand you too, so watch it. Come on, out of there. Hey, wow. Where'd you get this?
I got it on discount. I got it on discount at NEMA Outposts. Great place. Great babes there.
Jakku, that junk yard.
Man, I don't want any more of your weird cigars. And I hate working for you, but thank you, junkyard.
Chewie, hey, I told you we should have double-checked the Western Reaches. Who had it? The bang.
I stole it from Uncar Plunt. He stole it from the Urban Boys, who stole it from Duquesne, but I did not have sex with that Wookiee.
All this stealing brings to mind the story of your father's watch. I'll tell you girls about it later in my booth, but in the meantime, who stole it from me? Well, you tell him, Han Solo just stole back the Millennium Falcon for good.
I told you it was good.
Quack, 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 quack.
Chewbacca's a duck. You say this is the Millennium Falcon. Now, does it have direct drive? Are you Han Solo?
Well, I used to be. Han Solo.
Han Solo, the Rebellion General?
No, babe, the smuggler, man.
Did you just grab my butt? Wasn't he a war hero?
I did not grab your butt.
Quack, quack.
No, it was me.
Quack, 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 quack.
This is the ship that made the Kessel Run 14 parsecs, and that's pretty good.
Whoa, hang on now, 12. It was 12, not 14. Oh, I got more now. Hey, some move, Milka, put a compression on the ignition line.
Now, Uncar Plut did. I thought it was a mistake, too. It puts too much stress on the hydraulic.
Yeah, you're right. Wait, this guy is good. Surely, throw him in a pod. We'll drop him at the nearest inhabited planet.
Oh, yeah, okay. Just waiting for more.
No, wait, no. Hey, we need your help. I need a wingman.
Wow, wait, my...
You know, this droid has to get to the resistance base as soon as possible to cover for me and before the wife comes home.
He's carrying a map to Luke Skywalker in his pocket or something. It looks like it anyway. You are the Han Solo that fought with the Rebellion. You knew him.
Yeah, I know Luke. I know him. Don't tell me. Wait. Wow, a rat-tar's gotten loose.
Wait, a what? Did you say a rat-tar? Hey, you're not hauling rat-tars on this freighter, are you?
It's funny you ask, because yes, I'm hauling rat.
Oh.
Tars.
Oh, boy. On the control panel, we have a transport ship. It's landing on the freighter. Han is very fearful.
Oh, great. It's the Guavian Death Gang. They sound like a gangster rap group. They must have tracked us from Nan Throne.
Nan?
Ray?
Oh, okay. What is a raftar?
Well, they're big and dangerous like Donald Trump.
Oh. Hey, the hands are big and dangerous. I'm not dangerous. I'm not dangerous. I gotta tell you.
You've never heard of the Trillium Massacre?
No, I haven't. I switched voices. It's okay. I'm here now.
Good.
I got three of them going to King Pranah.
Three? Oh, my gosh. Blue, how'd you get them on board?
Hey, it's crazy, but I used to have a bigger crew.
Wank. Wank, wank.
Even Chewie turned into a duck. It's budget cuts. They're hitting everybody. Get below deck and stay there till I say so. Don't even think about taking the foul cut.
What about BB-8?
BB-8 stays with me until I get rid of the gang. Then you can have him back and be on your...
Way.
But what about the raptors? Where are you keeping them?
Suddenly, there is that terrifying a grotesque raptor, giant linguica, a cull, slams into the cargo container with the behind fin, whose heart is stopped.
Hey, look, wow, there's one.
What are you gonna do?
The thing I always do, I talk my way out of.
Come on.
It just takes a while. Yeah, Chewie's right. Chewie's so high right now, it's crazy.
And see.
Wow, that was good. I like that.
All right. Wow, we're taking requests. This is great. Right? All right. We are in this one. All right. Who got the biggest laughs? I saw Politic as Ice King.
Who am I?
Politic.
I usually don't discuss politics, but or religion.
As Ray, want to bring Azula back? The fans say yes. I keep hearing Jimmy Stewart out there. Bill said he wanted to do someone else, though.
Well, I can do a couple.
Jimmy Stewart is now Finn.
Finn.
Finn. Finn is Jimmy Stewart.
Yeah.
As Tasu Leech, Bill, how about Donald Trump? I can't get enough of it.
You like that? Okay.
Yeah, I can't get enough of it.
Get him out. Get him out of here.
Want to narrate it? Cheeseburger? How about Daphne? Narrate it? Daphne?
Okay, okay.
All right.
Emily Elizabeth.
Emily Elizabeth will narrate. And Han Solo, how about Cartman? Yeah. Cartman was the biggest. I've heard the biggest round of applause for Cartman. All right. That's everybody.
Sweet.
Clifford, a portal's opening, and the Guavian, what is it? Guavian death gang enters. One man in a suit, about a tick, and five security soldiers in badass uniforms with round face helmets, Clifford.
And it was absolutely incredible. Han Solo, you are a dead man.
Well, 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 better kid, what is the problem?
Why? I'll tell you, Han Solo, I'm gonna kick you right in the boing loins. You're a dead man. The problem, Han, is that we
loaned you... I gotta say, the problem is we loaned you $50,000 for this job, and that's, of course, a chicken fee for me. I got $5 billion in the bank, maybe. But,
Can you see them? Where are they?
No.
I heard you also borrowed $50,000 from Kangela. Huh? What?
Bill, you're Tasu Leech.
Who am I?
Yeah, Donald Trump.
What the hell did you just say?
Donald Trump is Tasu Leech.
Oh, I thought he was Balatik.
Yeah.
Yes, Balatik is Ice Cake.
Oh.
Bill's not on the mic again, man.
It's my fault, I told him.
Balatik. Okay.
Yes.
We're very prepared.
Start right there. After no.
Fever tick.
Go.
Those are the worst kind. Where are we starting from?
Right there after no.
No!
Hey, I heard you also borrowed $50,000 from Canter Club.
Hey, you know you can't trust those little freaks. How long have we known each other?
Oh, I'm right. yes.
They have blasters, but I've got fire.
The question is... Who's Flynn? Okay, Brad, this thing's going off the rails. I'm just going to slam in here with politics.
That was me.
The question is...
I didn't do that. Where the hell are we? I'll read off the yards. A lot of them.
The question is, how much longer will we know each other? How long? We want a wizard box back. Now.
Listen to me, you son of a bitch. You think I'm that bag of cheap? I spent that money. I am not a Jew, that Kyle.
Yeah, well, Kanja Club wants their investment back, too.
I never made a deal with Kanja Club.
Yeah, tell that to Kanja Club.
Oh, wait. Another portal opens. Han's face goes white as he turns to the other end of the corridor where he sees Jetta and she's such a bitch. And then there's also Kanye Club members appear. Oh, no.
Oh, Tasha Leech, it's good to see you.
I hope so. It's over for you, you know.
Boys. You're both gonna get what I promised. Have I ever not delivered for you before? About cheesy piss and everything.
Yeah, twice.
What was the second time?
Your game is old, yo. There's no one in the galaxy left for you to swindle.
No more left for you to hide.
A BB unit? The First Order's looking for one just like it. And two fugitives.
Yeah, this is the first I've heard of it. How strange, you guys.
Below start crawling fast, and they quickly arrive at a junction box area.
Wait. If we close the blast doors in that corridor, we can trap both gangs, and they will never recover from their humiliation!
Who's Finn? Oh, that's me.
Close the blast doors from here?
Resetting the fuses should do it.
Oh, okay.
Ray and Finn begin resetting the fuse boxes. Large containers start to open, and a giant raptor slithers out of its cage. It's so scary.
You guys, I'm totally serious right now. I've got a bad feeling about this, and I'm sailing away.
Oh, no.
Oh, no, what?
Wrong fuses.
Uh-oh.
You miscalculated.
Kill them and take the droid.
Now, this was a mistake.
Huge, you are banished.
And scene.
And scene.
All right, here we go. Wow. All right. We need to get back on track.
Who?
Maggie Smith's sister.
Maggie Smith, Professor McGonagall. Also.
Hey, it's Utah. You should do Joseph Smith.
Hey, you know what? While he's putting this next thing together, I just want to take a second and tell you guys sincerely. I know I've met a lot of you, and you know that I kid around a lot and everything like that, but I'm totally, totally serious when I say that this con is so awesome, not just because of Dan Farr and Brian who run the thing and all the people that work at it, but because of you guys. And I consider myself so blessed, and I know I speak for all of us when I say how grateful we are to meet you guys, how much we love meeting you guys. We're going to be downstairs after this, so come see us and hang out. It's going to be awesome. All right? The best, man, seriously.
All right, we got one, maybe two.
Oh, okay.
I got the hits. I got Chewbacca as Bill Cosby. I got Han Solo as William Shatner, Jess. I got it narrated by Dog, because everyone loves dogs. I got Sumo from Clarence.
Who's he?
He's General Hux.
General Hux is Sumo.
Sumo.
Okay.
Gray, I got Sam Manson back as Kylo Ren. I got SpongeBob back. Wow, look at that. SpongeBob is Ray.
Wait, SpongeBob is Ray?
Yeah.
Oh, God. Okay, and the narrator is Dog.
Yeah, we got Snoke, who has to be Goofy. All right, and we got two random one-liners, which always... Who do you want to bring up? You name somebody. We have a script, but I can't see anybody. Who wants to come up here and read a line? Dude, how about this guy right here? Can you read?
Somebody up. Yeah, that little dude right there.
Yeah, dude.
He looks like he can read.
Bill is
awesome. Come on, round of applause. Let's hear a round of applause for Rylie.
Right now.
All right, he's going to be great about it. All right, hang on. Talk amongst yourselves while we get him set up.
He just said, who am I?
Jess, entertain the crowd.
Haven't you noticed how bad we are at this? We don't know.
So, hey, if we come back here next time, are you guys going to come see us again? I freaking love that, you guys. Seriously. You know what? I really like living where I live because I live near Shatner and he thinks I'm Gene Simmons, but if I was going to move, I think I'd move here. Because I got to be honest, there's good restaurants, the dudes are cool, and the chicks are really freaking hot, man. Seriously. It's been awesome. And all you girls who have groped me, I just want to say thanks.
Great.
Story?
Christopher Walken story.
What's my? You mean the one when I met him that time?
Restaurant reservation.
Oh, the restaurant one. You guys want to hear how I get reservations at restaurants? Okay, so this is good incentive. If any of you are thinking about dating me, we never have to worry about getting a table anywhere because I take care of that shit. This is how I do it, right? If you call up and they say that they're booked because a lot of restaurants in LA are like super trendy and they book up in advance, I call up, they say, no, we don't have anything available. I say, no problem, dude. I call them back like 5 minutes later and this is what I do. Okay, they answer the phone. They'll say, hello, thank you for calling Spago. Can I help you? And I say, yes, tell me, who's the manager on duty today? And they'll go, that would be Brian. I go, can I speak to Brian, please? My name is Trevor. I'm the personal assistant to Christopher Walken. Right? And they go, oh, yeah, hang on, I'll go get him, right? So the guy comes to the phone, he goes, hello? I go, yes, is this Brian? He goes, yes, it is. I say, you're the manager? He says, yes, this is. Please hold for Christopher Walken. Right? He goes, okay, and I put the phone down, and I go like this. And I pick the phone back up, and I go, hey, Brian, listen, it's me. I got some friends. They want to come in tonight. I know you're booked, but here's the thing. I consider it a favor if you get them like a great table, maybe some free appetizers, pay for their parking, and make sure that they never have an empty glass on the table. I consider that a personal thing. Sure, Mr. Walker, what time are they going to be here? They're going to be there at 8. They look like they're in Kiss. You're going to love these guys. And we show up, man, and it's like we don't pay for nothing, and it's like screwing the system, which is awesome, right? That's a true story, dude.
All right. If we can get through it, we only got two scenes left. So
let's do it, dude.
Everyone knows their parts. Do we need to go over
it? No,
again?
I didn't remember. Oh, yeah, Cosby and somebody else.
Narrator is Dog, General Hux is Sumo, and Ray is SpongeBob.
Yes,
I got it, baby.
Hey, would you guys rather hear Shatner or Wacko? I'm changing that, dude.
So Shatner, then. Okay.
Yeah. Crystal clear. Thanks.
Okay.
Here we go. The next 8 pages are a montage of everyone running around screaming and being eaten by raptors, and a narrow escape by Finn and Ray. Well, almost like a Scooby-Doo cartoon. We cut
on. Keepers.
Like the starship's haunted. We cut on, trying to open the door, and Chewie gets hit in the shoulder by enemy fire.
Oh, I've been hit by enemy fire and a whole bunch of lawsuits.
Hello? Chewie, are you okay?
Oh, Han!
Hey, you, close the door behind us. You take care of Chewie. He needs a lot of help these days.
Oh, my God, I need a lot of help these days.
Han races through the cockpit. Ray enters fast, moves past him to Chewie's seat.
Hey, where are you going?
Unc-Ot Clot installed a fuel pump, too. If we don't prime that, we're not going anywhere.
Oh, I hate that guy.
Yeah, and you could use a co-pilot.
Well, I've got one. He's back there. Now, what's the thrust? We're going out of here at light speed.
From inside the hangar? Is that even possible?
I never ask those questions until after I've done it. Hey, this is not how I thought this day was going to go. Angle the shields. Hang on back there.
No problem.
Wow! Come on, baby, don't let me down. What?
Compressor. Oh, Han doesn't like it, but she's right. He hits the switch again, and the hyperdrive fires. At the hangar door, Bala Tick makes a call.
Information of First Order that Han Solo has been the droid they want. And it's aboard the Millennium Falcon.
Yeah. I wasn't sure where you were going there.
Dwarves, the droid will soon be delivered to the Resistance. Leading them to the last Jedi. If Skywalker returns, the new Jedi will rise!
Supreme Leader, I take full responsibility for that.
Oh, okay. General, our strategy must now change.
The weapon clearance, it's ready. I believe the time has come to use it. We shall destroy the government that supports the resistance, the Republic. Without their friends to protect them, the resistance will be vulnerable, and we'll stop them before they reach Skywalker.
Go! Oversee preparations.
Oh, yes, Supreme Leader.
There's been an awakening. I'm awake. Can you feel it?
This is the first Ventress as Kylo Ren. Yes.
There's something more. The droid we seek is aboard the Millennium Falcon in the hands of your father, Han Solo.
I am Sith, so he means nothing to me.
Even you, Master of the Knights of Ren, have never faced such a test.
But the grace of your training, I will not be seduced.
We shall see. We shall see.
And see. Funk. Great job. Thank you, Rylie. 9 years old, baby. Rylie. Coolest guy at the con.
Coolest guy at the con. Rylie. Yes.
All right. Last scene, folks.
Hey, look, man. We're going to go back downstairs. Are you guys going to come say hi?
All right, they will all be signing after this. When we're done, we're going to do a big picture, too. We want you all in it.
Oh, yeah, you guys all got to stand up.
You all
got to
stay here.
Because I'm going to text it to my mom, because she doesn't believe me when I tell her about this shit, so you got to be there, too.
All right, last scene. We're going to, a brand new one. The Powerpuff, the narrator from Powerpuff.
Okay, we got that.
You're going to narrate.
Sugar, spice, and everything nice. These were the ingredients chosen.
As Finn, Bill, how about Yosemite Sam?
Okay.
That one hurts me.
No. As Ray, how about Vicky? Vicky Bear. Catwoman.
Oh, yeah!
Catwoman is Vicky. As Chewbacca, Gary the Snail.
Oh, I think Gary's good.
You guys are dying out there. All right. As Han Solo, Roger Rabbit. Yeah. All right, this is it, folks. Enjoy. Last scene.
Sorry. I was just realizing that my glasses are doing absolutely nothing. I think I need a new one.
The city of Millennium Falcon. Day. Alarm sounding. Problems everywhere. In the lounge, Finn wraps a bandage on Chewie's shoulder.
Hey, wait a second. Is this an electrical overload?
Oh, I can fix that. Don't worry.
Oh, boy. You're almost as sexy as my beautiful wife, Jessica. But the coolant is leaking.
Wow, don't be a bad kitty. Try transferring auxiliary power to the second tank.
I would love to transfer our power to your second tank.
Tank's off limits.
We should just stop it.
Hey, come on. I need help with this giant hairy thing.
What?
Stop moving, Chewie.
Hey, wait a second. If you hurt Chewie, you're going to deal with me. And when I'm mad, I'm not such a funny bunny.
Hug him? He almost killed me 6 times. Which is fine.
This hyperdrive blows. That's gonna be pieces of us in 3 different systems. Hey, what'd you do?
Well, I just bypassed this little old compressor. Meow.
Han passes BB-8 as he walks back to the lounge to check on Chewie.
Move over, ball! Nah, don't say that. You did super. Just rest. Oh, good job, kid. And thanks for lunch.
Han,
Oh, yeah.
You're welcome.
So, you're a couple of fugitives, eh?
Yep.
Oh, I may have robbed a bank or two, but the First Order wants that map.
Every time she talks, I get a funny tingling sensation in my overalls.
Finn is with the Resistance. I'm just a scavenger. And when I want something, I find it in your overalls.
That's not my lucky rabbit's foot!
It's
too easy, dude. Okay. Yeah. Where am I, dude? I got all confused because that excited me. That's it.
I got it. Sounds like Ray has an overall plan. BB-8 rolls forward and suddenly projects a holographic map that fills the room.
This map's not complete. It's just a piece. Ever since Luke disappeared, people have been looking all over for him.
Oh, why'd he leave?
Because he wanted to go play the Joker on Batman.
Do you know what happened to him?
Yeah, there's a lot of rumors. I know he was in a car accident a long time ago, but he looks terrific now. The people who know him the best think he went looking for the first Jedi temple.
You know what's awesome? I gotta just do a quick sidebar. Mark's my buddy, right? And the first time I met him, I was so excited to talk to him about Star Wars, and all he wants to talk about are comic books. No, seriously, I go, Mark, tell me something, man. Did you have to practice to get good with a lightsaber? And he goes, no, but you know what's interesting? Is Superman originally didn't have a shield on his chest. It was just the giant ass, that's all it was. Anyway, let's get back.
The Jedi were real?
Hell, I used to wonder about that myself. Thought it was a bunch of mumbo-jumbo. Magical power hold together good, evil, the dark side of the light. Crazy thing is, it's true. The Force, the Jedi, all of it, it's all true.
That was like a monologue, dude.
Say even Chewie agrees. Hey, you rest, little buddy. You want my help? You're getting it. Gonna see an old friend. Sure, get your droid home, cause this is our stop.
Oh, don't
folks,
stop.
Big round of applause. Thank you.
Thank you.
You guys, give it up for TwistedToonz. We're gonna do a group photo right here, guys. We're gonna do a group photo.